Have you ever wondered how your lungs work? I'm going to show you how to make a simplified model of the lungs using a plastic bottle and balloons. Then we can take a look at some real plastinated organs to see what a human lung actually looks like. The first thing we are going to do is cut the bottom off of our plastic bottle and try to make sure there are no sharp edges sticking out. Next, take one of your balloons and cut off a small piece of the top of the balloon. Then tie a knot on the bottom of the balloon as if you would have blown it up normally. This next step is one where you might need a little help. Take the open end of your balloon, stretch it out a little, and then cover the bottom of your bottle with it, making sure that the knotted end is on the outside. Now, take your second balloon and put it inside the top of the bottle, but use the open end to secure it around the top. If it doesn't stay very well, feel free to use tape or string to hold it in place. Just don't cover the opening of the bottle. To make the lung model act like our real lungs, just push and pull on the bottom balloon like this. This may seem confusing right now since it doesn't look much like a lung, but remember, this is just a model to help us understand how the mechanics of the lung work. The bottom balloon is going to act like one of our muscles called the diaphragm, and the top balloon is going to be one of our two lungs. The diaphragm is very important for breathing because it helps make room in our chest for our lungs when we inhale. As it contracts, the diaphragm creates a vacuum in our chest that allows us to take in air. When it relaxes, it helps push air back out as we exhale. I'm cutting out the shape of a person to put on my bottle to make it look like the balloon lung is inside their chest. You should see the lung balloon shrink and grow as you move the diaphragm balloon. Now let's take a look at some real plastinated lungs. Here we have two different plastinated lungs. This is just one single lung, and this is a pair of lungs. You can see these are still attached. Neither of these have air or any bodily fluid in them, so they are much smaller than they would be in your body. Can you tell what the major difference is between these lungs? If you said the color, you're correct. This is a healthy lung, which you can tell by its pinkish color. These are a pair of smoker's lungs. You can see the dark discoloration from the buildup of tar in the lung tissue. When you breathe in, the air follows a specific pathway. First, it will enter through your mouth or nose, into the pharynx, then the trachea, which you can still see part of here, followed by the right and left primary bronchi to the secondary bronchi, tertiary bronchi, bronchioles, and finally the alveoli, which is the site of gas exchange in the lungs. Smoking and vaping are very harmful for your lungs and can make it more difficult to breathe over time. The best ways to keep your lungs healthy are to exercise regularly, eat a healthy diet, and avoid smoking, vaping, or breathing in any other toxic chemical.